What do you think of G2 Reckless? I don't know. People are saying I leaked something, but I didn't leak anything, and I'm very smart. So I will never leak stuff, because I'm smart.
Are you playing Kamado?
Yeah, you wanna kill snipe?
Yeah, we can try to kill snipe.
Report Wukong first. You report him?
Why do you wanna report him?
Try harding increases. We even get the same game.
Wait, did you get the game?
Did you get game?
No.
Isn't this against the rules?
You are still in queue though, right?
Yeah. You know, I had Abadaga last game, I took his midwave and he went AFK.
Wait, are you serious?
Yeah, he put the ball on me, armed me, and then he went AFK for like 4 minutes. The guy is still having a good preseason.
How is AP to it? You like
it's
that
really
shit?
Strong. Yeah, it's really strong.
But do you play it on AD or a support?
Support, and then you just roam. You just roam and kill all lanes and all, you know.
But like, you don't deal that much damage with your basics when you have Nashor 2 still, right? It's just all about E.
But the Nashor does like 100 anyway. It's like
I know, but it's more about the like E and passive, right?
Yeah. I think it's more that people don't expect.
This is your champion for Twitch, Brandt, Xerath, Yuumi.
Well, not Yuumi, she's so bad.
Is she bad now?
Yeah, things was removed, so the healing is not even noticeable.
Wait, what happened in the game? Did you get Q-Pop?
No.
Okay, I'm gonna decline.
Okay, those snitches.
No, what happened in the game where you had 0-10 Draven?
Okay, so this happened. And not because I dislike Jankos, but he ganked bot, and then he just ran into Yasuo and died.
Yeah, but you were the only one that was not inting from what I can see.
Well, I don't wanna be that guy. And I hate to flame people.
Do you?
But we had Jankos off a tank.
Come on, man. But the games happen. They really do.
Yeah, every game is off a tank.
Okay, let's check his match history. Because I don't believe you.
Well, numbers can lie.
See, he's winning a lot. What do you mean?
On everything. Okay, 1-4 Echo.
He just had a bad game on Graves.
Look at everything. Okay. Look at everything that is in the tank except the Kha'Zix.
Okay, and there is 24 Graves, 15 free Kha'Zix.
Okay, are you telling me my sister is a Kha'Zix one trick? She's 5. Anybody can play this.
I mean, I can agree with you. Kha'Zix is the most fucking unskilled.
No, you can't take Graves Kha'Zix as example when there's that broken. That's just not a thing.
But this is meta, like. This is what's strong, so you play them, and obviously that's how the league works. For the past 20 fucking years of this game, the most broken champions are the easiest one.
So you're gonna tell me the Jankos is as good as other junglers off tanks, is that what you're saying?
I think it's just... I think sometimes you just lose games.
Asking pro players about another pro player is not doable.
Of course it's not doable, because we see the game more in like you would play against those... For example, I play against this guy, right, in... 5v5, and I won't judge him by 1-9 Graves solo queue game, right?
Well, every game I've had him, he's just been...
I got game, I accepted.
Oh yeah.
Autopilot.
What's your team?
Abedage, Weakside, Joey, Kha'Zix and Cookie.
Yeah, good luck with that one.
Okay, pleasure to do business with you, Rats.
Yeah, thank you.
I don't wanna play Eve again, but I think it's Eve game. It's clearly Eve game. So I need AP and I need champion to reach them. I don't wanna play Eve, but I legit have to if I wanna win. Okay, he went for Nocturne, I like this. We both gonna chill. So we both gonna farm for level 6 and then we will see who has better laners. This will be the matchup for this game. Thought on inspiration versus sorcery, you don't have anything to take in inspiration, because this is just useless. Like, yeah, boots are cool, but this, item haste, summoner spell haste. And this gives you 40 AP, minute 20. Like, this is like around 1k gold, minute 20. Which is when Eve shines the most. I mean, she shines the most, the more the game goes, right? But, you know what I mean. Once you have, like, proto belt, and you're on your way to Lich Bane.
Nope. So the only bad thing about picking Nocturne this game is... I don't really think we have great lanes to gank pre- like, Nocturne against Morgana and Senna means I can't... it's hard to gank pre-6. That's like the only bad thing about being Nocturne, I think. It's hard to gank pre-6.
Something spicy that he could do this game is just do red buff into my Gromp. Cause that's something I would clearly not expect from Nocturne. But he just does standard gameplay, which is start bot lane when you have Alistar, because your bot lane is fucking useless. Full Q towards top lane, take top cap, I will take bot cap, we're gonna base on 28 CS. Full Q again. I should have better bot lane this game, better mid, he should have better top lane. Based on champions.
Eclipse. I'll die for this. She killed me. Not sure if this is worth it.
She won't make it. Wait, no, I won't make it. I really won't make it. It's 1-for-1, which is good for Kpiora. He's getting killed in matchup like this, it's always better for top laner.
Oh shit. Hey, that seems a little bit in. I'm coming, guys. I feel like the Kpiora can actually outplay this, no? She's level 6. I am coming. Wait, I still did keep that.
When will I see a Master Yi game from you? Cheeky smiley face.
Well, I guess so. I mean, that was he had to peel for himself. It made sense what he did there. I am almost level 6. I would like to get level 6. He was also 6 now.
Hi Jankos, quick question.
I think Morgana should walk here with me because there is nothing to do. Like, catching the save doesn't give her anything. Ultimate? Nice.
I don't really win. I didn't see he... I mean, at least I got the minion. I didn't really see he went on me.
Nocturne has no ult. No, he has ultimate still. So this is still risky, but if Lucian goes for this shit...
Yeah, I feel like I don't really know how to help them. They are just kind of dying and it is a hard lane. Yeah, like kinda counter picked as well. So it's not easy for them.
The problem with Nocturne is that this champion is like way too ultimate dependent.
Fuck, but now he's gonna kill Lucian.
Maybe he will. Maybe he won't. Yeah, exactly. And now what is he supposed to do for the next 2 minutes? When I don't have ultimate, I can still kill people, right? He can't.
Damn, he's dead. The guy is fucking cute there without me. I mean, they had to have a ward somewhere. There's no way. I think when I was ulting, they also had ward on me, but I'm not sure where. I mean, it's a guess, right? He could also just flash because he was expecting the flash. Or he was expecting me to ult there. Oof.
Yo, Rat, thank you for the host. I'm playing against your favorite jungler, look. And he's off tank. Please, don't flame him. It's just solo queue.
Yikes. I guess we got the Herald though.
Not sure if that was war for him, but we'll see. I can respect that, not gonna lie, I can respect that. No, he doesn't know where I go, so there's a chance he will think I went to bot to crab. And I will catch him at Raptors.
Yeah, I was guessing which invade would she do, because she would for sure do an invade there, because she's strong and she has ult, right? So I can't really fight her. So he was basically, I was guessing which side of the map does he go, which side of the map do I choose.
Like the most annoying thing in this game.
Well, that's a Drake.
That's why I didn't want to flash, because LeBlanc clone is super annoying.
And I think as soon as Morgana leaves, I could try to get a kill here. But will Morgana be okay? She has Zhonya. Her first item was a Zhonya, huh?
We see Nocturne should have Ezreal. Weak side Joe is really mad. He's really mad. Danger, danger, danger. She has Zhonya, right? Yeah, she has Zhonya. Okay, I missed my ultimate. I wanted to jump here. Still got him, I guess. Ah, wait, it's solo cooldown because of the ultimate hunter 5 stacks. It's so much cooler.
Yeah, I can't really join that easily on this. We have to kite this.
Ay ay ay.
That was slightly close. That was like slightly close. That would be 1 minute now. Wait for me, sweetie. I got my ult, so I wouldn't really mind ulting somewhere.
Ah, oh, he feared me off.
Okay, so this is a lot of gold, but I'm also
get him, boys. And that's why I don't like fucking Magi, because I would lose all my stacks now. He got my Shadon, but it's Nocturne. This champion is so useless that Shadon won't help him, I would say.
We have a lot of 2 damage. No, actually we have only... Wait, no. What the fuck? What are they doing? What are they doing? Actually, just griefing. Why don't they just wait for us? I have my ult. Well, not really anymore, but, you know, without spawn. Because I think like... The thing is, we never got a 5v5, which, you know, makes sense, because they have Fiora to split push and they have Eve to make a lot of picks. But if we actually are in a scenario where we are grouped, I can ult and it's not that easy for the AD carries to teamfight against our champions. But we never really got to that point, so it's hard to see if we would win that or not, right? I mean, wait, this is the same LeBlanc I had earlier in the morning. This guy was in team as well. Well, that's not good. Think could be decent, actually. Could be a decent fight. But that is a Nash kind of fight, so that's pretty decent, I guess. And that's the thing about like playing Nocturne, right? If you are ever in a situation again when people are grouped, when you can actually use your ult, when they don't see things, it's so much harder for them to make a correct decision. It's so much harder for them to team fight. But when we always fight split, which, you know, we do because they have Eve and Eve is really fucking obnoxious and, you know, he's like playing very well, then it's much harder. Anyway, they got the Drake, we got the Nash.
This Alistar is just kinda annoying. I just need to get Black Shield and then I can go and kill them all. Okay. And now I got the 1k gold. Put an ultimate, man! FF this game. And honor Camille. Fast. They should know about me being here. Ezreal is E. Big mistake, bro. He's so fucking fast.
Yeah, I mean, I do have ult. Very aware of that. Fuck. Oh. Don't think she can run with a flash like that. I do have to use my stopwatch there.
Well, Flash was not the best, but I got the kill.
Okay, well, Ezreal seems kind of unleashed. At the same time, we are very low, so I'll third base. What the fuck? He was one-shotting me, by the way. No, that was another one-shot.
If I kill him, I will die to Nocturne. Really? Ah, he got Hex Drinker now. Imagine I had Void stuff, right? Now he bought Hex Drinker. A lot of things can happen here. Yeah. That's the thing, a lot of things can happen. And the bad thing happened.
Should be game over, I think. I guess he did assassinate. Wait, what? They're losing this? How? I hope they can deal with. Yeah, they can. Wait, what? You can't just loot me like that! You can't just loot me with an item! That's illegal! Well, you die now anyway. He just looted me with an item. Okay, I missed my Q of Flash. I agree. But he just looted me with an item, man! What the fuck? Nice Flash. Hey! Stop. I mean, I also used Spell Shield for nothing because I didn't think about him looting me with an item. So, yeah. Well, it is official now. It is official now. Oh, look, I have 4 honors. That's Pog. And all of us did very similar damage. That's also pretty Pog. He did so much more than everyone else. But Ezreal, I mean, for a Pog jump, I guess he couldn't re-Pog much. Yeah, it is official now. It is official, guys. So if you ask me right now about, you know, perks, he is indeed leaving G2 Esports. He is no longer with us. It was a great 2 years playing with the same roster. Unfortunately, nothing can last forever. And yeah, I was as shocked as you were probably when I heard the news. I didn't really know this would happen. I didn't really expect it during Worlds at least. I mean, I heard rumors during Worlds already that this could happen. And then when Perix told us, I was like kind of shocked, but I was not that shocked because I already heard rumors. And then, you know, everything that was happening in the background with all of this, you know, like decision of Perix leaving and his decision and the team decision and everything. I cannot really go into details about that. I can only tell you that, yeah, we will no longer be playing with Perix for next year. He will probably find a good home, so don't worry about him. He will be fine with his new teammates in New York. He taught me a lot, so I really respected him. I do still respect him, of course. right? But he really taught me a lot through the years in G2 Esports. Well, I was playing with him 3 years, the same roster 2 years, right? But I was playing with Pesh for 3 years, and I think he actually made me so much better than I used to be when I was still in H2K. So even though he was younger than me, he really stepped up as like a leader and as a good player, and you know, you could always count on him. So it was a good time, you know. There is no sadness. I mean, of course, it would be fun to have the last dance along Perks in 2021, you know, S5 or something. But yeah, nothing can last forever, and we will not play with the same roster next year. I mean, it is sad, right? But it's like, I mean, I was aware this was happening, so I accepted the decision long ago. Of course, on my streams, I had to say, oh, it's only rumors, I don't know what you guys are talking about. I mean, that's like, that's not pretty normal, right? Saying it's rumors as a pro player basically means you're saying it's happening, don't worry, bro. But no, because anything you ask me and I say it's rumors, you guys will always say leaked. If you'd ask me Faker is joining G2 Esports and Caps is moving to AD carry position, you guys would be like, and I would say, oh, it's just rumors. You guys would be like, leaked. So basically, no matter what I say, you guys will say leaked. So I don't know what to say because, yeah, I mean, no matter what I say, it's leaked. Did I just lead Faker into G2 Esports transfer? Shit, guys.